To our dear friend, Lynn Claire Santer, ladies and gentlemen, it's a real pleasure for Robin, myself, and Ali, in his thoughts, representing Passion for Peace, to be present at this special night of recognition for the wonderful things Lynn has achieved, culminated with her book titled The Unbelievable Life of Lynn Santer. You are probably thinking, how on earth does a Hasidic Orthodox rabbi meet with Lynn, let alone Robin, my Christian colleague, and Ali, a Muslim and a personal pilot of Saddam Hussein, not your average Charlie's Angels. I met Lynn and Claire at the sad passing of her dear husband and father in the hospital. And as we were chatting, I asked Lynn, what do you do for a living? And she replied, you know, I'm writing at the moment the life story, the autobiography of Saddam Hussein's former personal pilot. And that's when I decided to take out life insurance. Are you kidding? I said, why can't you write a biography about some football legend or something else but Saddam Hussein's pilot? But after the shock wore off, I realized that if Lynn is involved with Ali, it's got to be kosher. I was actually intrigued to meet Ali at Lynn's home.
The footage you are now seeing is of a current affair reporter, Kirstine Lum, with Lynn on Tiger Island in 2006. These two ladies actually first met when Kirstine was working as a producer on Channel 9 Sunday program back in 2001. She is currently on an important assignment with a current affair in Japan. Over the years, together Lynn and Kirstine produced three major cover stories together.
The very touching look at the life of Ali al-Wahhabi.
Flight to Freedom, the story of Captain Ali al-Wahhabi's escape from the Iron Fortress of Baghdad, where he was once the personal pilot for the ruthless tyrant Saddam Hussein. The Wizards of Oz, where Lynn and Kirstine had a lot of fun on a story prompted by Lynn's latest novel at the time, a fictional supernatural adventure dubbed as Harry Potter for grown-ups called Professor Midnight. And a story that took them a long 6 years to get off the ground, The Birds and the Big Cats. The story of how the iconic and legendary Alfred Hitchcock star of The Birds, Tippi Hedren, and her close friend Lynn Santer took on some of the most powerful men on Earth to expose ongoing brutal atrocities against endangered big cats.
Tippi is involved in similar conservation activities for all big cats and has been working with Australian author Lynn Santer in a quest to stop illegal and inhumane hunting practices around the world.
This is a real powerhouse of a woman. She, when she is involved with something, she is extremely focused.
They're racing against one another to kill more animals, rarer animals, and say, I shot one that's bigger than yours.
There are tens of thousands of these men, women, who are involved with hunting, and they take great pride in it. They don't like to make it public.
It was directly as a result of Lynn and Tippi planning a covert mission with ex-SAS commandos to expose these atrocities back in 2001 that Lynn's life came under a very unwelcome microscope. It is true to say that Channel 9 also played a pivotal role in the saga that unfolded.
The work that Lynn is doing, it's hard to put into words, and I just want you to try and understand the difference that education not only can but must make amongst children. And her book, back in 2007, she launched Magical Scarecrows, and I was lucky enough to be a part of that down at Dreamworld. And it's projects like that that are so, so important. Because if we can change the kids of today, if we can change the way they think, then there's a possibility, a very good possibility, that we can change the society of tomorrow. And Magical Scarecrows, with those wonderful, wonderful stories that inspire children, goes a long way towards doing exactly that.
When the first sun rose, it found us waiting. We shaped the land. We rode the wind. Look at us. been here before. We walked the desert sands, danced the streets of Egypt. We cut the stone that shaped the pyramids. We smiled with them long before others came to our shores. We washed our wounds in the Nile, slept in the wings of a scarab. We made love to Nefertiti. We have been here before. Raging in the night, long before the snake came to our children in the garden, we looked at God and saw our image in His eyes. Oh, when the first sun rose, it found us awake and waiting.
So this, ladies and gentlemen, is Lynn's favourite song. And I think you'll get the message here. And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll make it clear, I'll stake my care, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I've traveled each and every highway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, I traveled each and every byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I gave it up and I spit it out. I faced it all, and I stood tall. And cried. I've had my fill, my share of losing, and now as tears subside, I find it oh so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say,
say. Not in a shy way. Can you imagine them being shy? Oh no, oh no, oh no. I did my way. For what? As a man, what has he got? If not himself, then he has not to say the words he truly feels, and not the words of one who feels. The record shows I took the blows, and in it my. Hey, Lynn Santer, or should I call you Fred? Sir Santer, come up. Lynn Santer, ladies and gentlemen, and she did it her way. My pleasure, Father. Nice round of applause for a lady who doesn't know when to give it.
Find your doorway, may the bluebird sing your song. May no trouble travel your way, may no worry stay too long. May your heartaches be forgotten, may no tears be spilled. May your wildest dream come true. May